I'm 14 years old. Hi, I'm Matt, the in-house Metavers-ologist here at Redpepper. And welcome to another edition of Touch on Tech, where we cover the latest and emerging technology so we can share it with you.
Reality is a lie.
So if you think your real life house is a disaster, just wait until your virtual reality house in the future is just covered in dirt and needs a good power washing. Well, welcome to Power Wash Simulator, guaranteed to be the most relaxing video game you have ever played. Not even a point system on the thing. You don't have to do scores, you just go around cleaning up things and it feels nice. So if you're looking for a quick little side gig this summer, you may want to hop into VR and just power wash down some houses. Get a few extra bitcoins in that pocket. Do they have to pay taxes? Taxes on their power wash bucks? If you have a question about your taxes, just email at redpepperland.com. She is our in-house CPA that will be glad to assist you with all your tax needs. Just use the promo code Matt and Trevor sent you. One second. So people are breeding digital horses and making real money. It's kind of like the Kentucky Derby in the Matrix. You can buy a horse, own the horse, train the horse, race the horse, make money off the horse, and all the proceeds go to you. And the thing is, this horse runs 24/7. You're sleeping and your horse is racing and it's beating other horses and it's showing up in the morning with a big old purse of money for you. And how they guarantee that your horse is owned by you? Well, they prove it on the blockchain. These are NFT horses. So what's the advantage to a digital horse over a regular horse? Well, you don't have to give it food or water. And I guess if it's coming behind in a lot of races, you can download some Kung Fu right to it, and all of a sudden it's winning everything. Kung Fu horse. So Neuralink, which is Elon Musk's company that is putting brain threads in people's brains, has put them into a monkey, then now it allows it to play ping pong with its imagination. Doesn't even have to touch a controller, it just plays pong. So how does it do this? All these little Neuralink threads get put into your brain and it sends a signal off to a paired Bluetooth device, which can then interpret your brain signals and use machine learning to create actions around them. It can even predict what you're going to do before you even do it. Dear ASPCA, now that we have your attention, programming monkeys. So now that people are heading out of their homes a little bit more often, they're seeing things they haven't seen in quite a while. And if you're in Shanghai, you're seeing something you've never seen in quite a while, ever. It's a huge QR code made out of drones that you can scan with your phone, and it'll take you to a game that you can play on your phone. So huge QR codes floating in the sky is one thing, but what if there was a QR code on the moon or projected onto a cloud or even made out of birds? What if you could train birds to fly in the formation of a QR code? And since the US government replaced all the birds in 1962, then it should be quite easy to train them. Thanks for stopping by and spending some time with us. We hope to see you next time on another edition of Touch on Tech.